Look, I risk alienating my P1s by saying anything negative about Sarah Palin, so I won't say anything. Are you crazy? Are you out of your damn minds? She reminds me of a country western singer with the aw shucks pretending to be a president. What are you people, nuts? Yes, she says all the right things. Yes, she's a nice lady and her heart's in the right place. But you can see what happens when you have somebody who's unqualified step into the presidency because the people got emotional. Please don't do this to us, I say to myself. If the Republicans commit suicide with her, I quite don't know what I'm going to do. I'll tell you this, I'm not moving to New Zealand. That I can guarantee you. She's like Dolly Parton in her early days. Play a little country and western so they know what I'm talking about. I think we're going to mix Dolly Parton with... Yeah, that's like a Sarah... I could see that on the stage with Sarah Palin. Am I wrong? Guys, am I wrong? I'm not wrong. There goes the P1s. They're all... They were mad at me again. So when I first attacked Bush, they didn't know what to do. That was the end of the show for about 3 days till they came to their senses. I was right. You were wrong. Are you people nuts? Sarah Palin, president? I mean, you want Obama a second term? Go ahead. Make his day.
Second.
I don't want any American to ever close the door in their personal or their professional lives and put themselves in a box and say, heck yeah, I'm going to do that, or no way, I'm not going to do that, when we don't know what the future holds.
A mama grizzly rises up in me hearing things like that. You know, here again, cool, fine, come attack me. But when you make a suggestion like that, that certainly attacks
a kid. No, if you want Obama for a second term, just make sure that Palin is the Republican nominee. That's all. I didn't say she's bad. I didn't say her heart's not in the right place. I just know more about the American electorate than you do. And I know more about it than the stupid Republican Party does. And I am telling you that if they make that idiotic mistake of pushing her as their lead candidate, it's over. Obama will get a second term no matter how bad his presidency has been. That's my opinion. It's one man's opinion. Doesn't mean I don't agree with her politically. It doesn't mean I think she's a bad person. She's not electable as president. She does not have the, well, I don't want to use a word that was popular 8 years ago, gravitas. You want to use that one? He doesn't either. That doesn't mean that she's not the right person. We need a businessman. We need someone with guts, preferably someone who served in the military. That means we have nobody. And please don't tell me about Mr. Brown. God, please. I warned you, don't Obama-size these guys. You know, be a realist like I am. It's too early already to talk about it. We got the midterm elections to worry about before we get on to that, but it's everywhere you turn. The Tea Party convention was last Saturday. They had 400 people. I had 2,000 people at every event I've ever run. 1,500 to 2,000 people, I pack an auditorium, and people pay for it. It's not for free. I don't have a handlebar mustache, you know what I'm saying, with a Bowie knife to get them in there at the door. What are you talking about, 400 people? That's all that came to the Tea Party convention? They ran it like, oh, big deal. Great, I'm glad. And they charged $500 a piece? That's their right. They wanted to pay $500 a piece, it's their business. They wanted to pay $5,000 a piece, it's their business. What are the liberals complaining about? The reason they were complaining about is that they get the illegals in there and the other deadbeats who have nothing to do. They get them in there for nothing. So they hear that they get $500 a head. They went crazy. Huh? Ooh, can't we tax this somehow?